Welcome to our Spark demo. Spark is a combination of hardware and software built to recover data from damaged drives, which cannot be recovered with software alone. During this video, we will show how Spark handles a few common data recovery cases. Our first case is a Hitachi laptop drive. When we connect it directly to Windows through a USB drive bay, it appears in computer management. But opening it causes the computer to lock up for several minutes and then give an error. This happens because Windows runs into bad sectors and eventually gives up when it fails to read them. Now we connect it to Spark. We begin by starting a new project and running diagnostics. We manually repower the drive when prompted. Repowering is necessary for diagnostics because we can get a lot of important information about the drive only while it's initializing. With Power Control add-on, the drive will be repowered automatically without having to reconnect the power by hand. The diagnostic tests have all passed, so we double-click on the largest partition to start loading the file tree. During this process, all sectors containing file system metadata are copied to the image file stored on our PC, and then scanned to build a file tree. Spark maintains a live sector map, ensuring that all sectors are read only once, and all secondary reads are automatically processed from the image file on our PC. Now that we've built a file tree, we can either browse it manually or initiate a search to mark all files with a particular name or extension. All we have to do now is press the Save button to recover the files we selected. We are running into bad sectors, which are displayed in the sector map below and also counted under statistics. Accessing bad sectors is harmful to the drive and will eventually cause the drive to fail completely. Spark uses hardware reset commands to quickly abort bad sector processing, which greatly improves recovery speed and makes the recovery process much safer. Spark hardware is also very tolerant of a wide range of read instability issues, so it will never give up on the drive. Software tools cannot send reset commands, and instead can only wait for the drive to respond on its own. If the drive is degraded and cannot respond in a reasonable time frame, then software tools will error out and fail to recover the drive. The imaging setting is very important because it determines how Spark will process bad sectors. The Skip Bad setting uses a shorter read timeout and larger read block size. This is faster and less stressful for the drive, but leaves more sectors behind in bad blocks. Dig Bads is the opposite, where Spark gives the drive more time to respond and uses a smaller read block size, which allows us to recover more data from bad blocks. However, it takes more time and puts more stress on the drive. Typically, it is best to do two recovery passes, first on Skip Bads and then on Dig Bads. This way, the first pass prioritizes speed and safety, while the second pass maximizes data retrieval from areas that were missed on the first pass. Now that we've finished the first pass, we can see that the integrity of our recovered files is being displayed. Files without any bad sectors will show as integral, and files with bad sectors will show as corrupt. With Pro add-on, we can generate an HTML file report, which can be emailed to the customer to easily communicate the result of the recovery. Corrupt pictures will either fail to open or have some sections of the image missing. Now we will do a second recovery pass to reduce the level of corruption. We can either use the search function to mark all corrupt files or manually mark the files we want the most. After we make our selection, we change the imaging mode to Dig Bads and start the recovery again. Because Spark maintains a live sector map, it is retrying only the sectors which fail to read on the first pass, but this time it's reading one sector at a time to maximize data retrieval and giving the drive more time to respond before issuing a hardware reset. After the second pass, the level of data loss is greatly reduced, which improves the quality of our recovered images. Let's try another drive, this time a Western Digital Blue laptop drive. When we connect it directly to our PC, it takes several minutes, but eventually appears and shows a file tree. However, when we try to copy files, Windows gets stuck on bad sectors and cannot complete the copy process. After a full hour of waiting, we are still stuck at this screen. During this hour, Windows was damaging the drive by endlessly trying to read bad sectors, and at the end could not read even a single file. Now let's try it with Spark. We start a new project and begin loading the file tree as usual, but this time we can see that many sectors are being skipped and the process is moving slowly. The amount of sectors we recover at this step directly affects the number of files we will find. After the first pass, we found 70 gigabytes of files, so let's do a second pass on DigBads to find more. After the second pass, only one bad sector remains, and we found an additional 43 gigabytes of files. Because the drive responds very slowly, and there were many bad blocks on the first pass which were successfully retrieved on the second pass, there is good reason to suspect that the drive has a non-critical firmware issue. When we try to save the users folder, the process moves along very slowly and many files are corrupted. We can try to speed up the rate of recovery by checking the box to skip files with bad sectors, in which case Spark will immediately stop recovering a file as soon as it finds a single bad sector within it. But even with this setting enabled, the recovery process moves forward much too slowly to be practical. We cannot recover enough data following our usual process, so let's repair the drive's firmware. Level 2 solutions are appropriate when the problem is very slow operation and a large number of bad sectors, most of which become readable on the second pass. Now that the firmware repair process has completed, we can continue recovering the same files to see if it works better. This time, almost all sectors are being read and files are quickly being recovered. In this case, bad sectors and slow operation were due to a common firmware bug with Western Digital drives, which is nicknamed the slow responding issue. After it's fixed, the drive responds much better and we can easily recover what we need. The next drive is a Western Digital Black laptop drive. Windows cannot see this drive no matter how long we wait, so we connect it to Spark and start a new project. This time, most of the boot sectors and their copies were not readable, so we cannot see the right partition on the list. In this situation, we have to make a full image of the whole drive. When we start imaging, all sectors are coming back bad, so let's test the heads. To do this, we first have to build a head map, which requires the Pro add-on. During this process, Spark is mapping out the heads to figure out which head each sector belongs to. After the head map is built, we press the Media Test button to check each individual head. It turns out Head 0 cannot read at all, so we disable it and only read Head 1. Because we disabled one of the drive's two heads, we are skipping half of the data, so our results will be partial. Imaging Head 1 is proceeding well, with occasional bad blocks. Included with every Spark unit is a licensed version of RStudio to perform in-depth logical recovery scans on image files created by Spark. Now that we have our partial image, it's time to use RStudio to recover the files. We open the image which we created and it appears on the list of devices. We right-click on it, press Scan, and then OK. RStudio found a number of possible partitions. We select the largest of the green partitions and double-click on it. We found 235 gigabytes of files, some of which will be corrupt. We initiate a search to find and mark the files we are looking for. After we are satisfied with our selection, we press Recover Marked on the toolbar to save the files. As expected, some files are corrupt because we disabled one of the drive's heads. There were a lot of bad blocks during imaging, so we can improve the recovery result by doing a second imaging pass. Drives with one bad head are usually very fragile, so this time we will do the second pass on Balanced instead of DigBads to increase the chances that the drive will survive this imaging pass without crashing. After the second pass, we reduce the number of corrupt sectors from 6.6 million down to 1.1 million. Now we scan our image with RStudio once again, following the same process. This time, we found an additional 3 gigabytes of files. To recover even more data, we can do a third pass on DigBads, but the result will always be partial because of the disabled head. The only way to recover all data from this drive is to swap the heads from a donor drive in a clean air environment. Let's try another drive, this time a Hitachi. Windows cannot identify it, so we connect it to Spark. The drive does not identify even in Spark, so we cannot start a new project, but we can still run diagnostics to get a better idea of what's happening. As we can see in the log, Smart has failed, and we only have partial access to firmware modules and defect lists, making this a good candidate for firmware repair. For drives that don't identify, it's usually best to start the firmware repair process at level 1 and then try other levels if it turns out to be insufficient. After the firmware repair process, the drive identifies correctly, and we can now start a project and begin recovering data following the usual process. This drive had a corrupt translator in its firmware area, which was fixed in RAM. Because this is a RAM fix, it will be removed as soon as the drive loses power, and the drive will return to its original condition. For our last case, we will recover a solid-state drive RAID array. Because this is a RAID array spanning multiple drives, we will not see valid partitions in Spark, so we have to take full images of both drives in the RAID array as the first step. There were a lot of bad blocks during the first imaging pass, so we do a second pass on DigBads. After the second pass, only 8 bad sectors remain. A few bad sectors is all it takes for a RAID array to fail to initialize in a normal PC, but it is not a problem for Spark. We do the same thing with the second drive in the RAID array. Now that we have both images, we open them in RStudio, which automatically assembles the RAID array. All we have to do is double-click on it to generate the file tree. Finally, we can find and mark the files we want to recover, and then press Recover Marked to save them. This concludes the Spark demo video. Thank you for watching.